What's shaking YouTube? Daniel here, I'm back. This is episode 16, I believe, of the series. And yeah, excited to be back in front of the camera today to do another episode. I feel like there's some good updates to share and whatnot since the last one. Kind of getting in the rhythm of doing these just sort of whenever throughout the month, maybe one or two a month at most. Find every week is just a little bit sort of, there's not a lot that happens in a week, and I feel like I can just sort of make better videos if I have a little bit more to talk about, and also use the time that I'm not spending on these every week to, you know, do other videos and stuff too. So yeah, just kind of putting these up whenever I feel like the timing is right, basically. And yeah, that's kind of where things are at. But I've prepped some notes, so we'll just jump right into it. And yeah, thank you guys for tuning in and checking it out. Starting with gratitude, first thing that's kind of top of mind would just be the chance to travel a little bit. In these times, it's not as common right now, obviously, and it's definitely not something to do a lot of unless you really have to. But in this case, we were visiting Lisa's family up in Terrace, BC. So last week, I believe it was, was it already the week before that? Anyways, we went up to Terrace, and yeah, it was beautiful up there. It's kind of, you know, in the transition between fall and winter right now, so it was a little bit snowy up there already and stuff too. And yeah, just spent some really nice quality time with Lisa's family, and had a bit of a down week, just sort of, you know, resting a little bit, still doing a little bit of work every day, and actually shooting quite a bit, just different cool, you know, nature and adventure things around there. But otherwise, yeah, it's just kind of a chill week, and that was really nice. So very grateful to be able to travel, even if it is just a little bit, you know, right now in these times. So yeah. Other thing I'm grateful for is new camera gear. And this could probably already be, or I could also put this in like the wins or, you know, updates section of the episode here. But yeah, super grateful for new gear. I got the new drone going, so that's been cool, the DJI Mavic Air 2, so getting the hang of using that. Also finally bought a camera stabilizer, which was really cool. So very stoked to finally have like a good DJI Ronin S, so a very good, you know, camera stabilizer for mostly client work, but I'm sure I'll find some uses for it as well with just some of my side projects and some of my own personal content and stuff as well. So yeah, super grateful for that. And then lastly, I would just say friends. Very grateful for friends. I have some amazing ones in my life. They are very supportive and inspiring in many ways too. So yeah, just that's something to be grateful for sure. Moving on to updates. I picked some of the bigger ones. I shot and edited one of my biggest shoots of the year recently. I think it wrapped up about maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago at this point. And yeah, it was a fantastic shoot. It was for a local development company here in Vancouver, and it was, you know, kind of like documenting a lot of it's like a new high-rise they just built and launched. So it was just kind of documenting all the different sort of details and features of that building and stuff. So it was a 3-day shoot, and I think the edit maybe took 4 or 5 days as well. So all in all, it was, you know, one of my bigger ones for the year, and it was a good profitable one as well. So that's always good too. So yeah, and I think I learned a lot just about using my gear. And very, you know, going from one room to the next was very different, you know, settings. So just kind of learning on, you know, when to lean on auto settings and when to take over control and kind of set the scene and sort of set up lighting and all that stuff as you need it. So yeah, that was really cool. Good learning experience. Finished another website project, so that's another update. That one went a lot quicker, I would say. This time we built it on Squarespace. They had already kind of started on there, but just didn't really move it forward and didn't, you know, want to spend the time doing it. So yeah, I was able to go in there and, you know, build a website from scratch, you know, a 5 or 6 page website. you know, in a matter of a few weeks. And that was a little bit more profitable for me as well too. So that was a great project. It was for a fly fishing company out in like Eastern BC, I guess. I think it's Castlegar. Yeah, quite far away. And they have a sweet fishing tour guide company with no website. So yeah, it was awesome to get them online. And that was a good successful project. So glad that one happened and got completed. What else? I talked last time in the last update about pitching companies in Terrace, because Lisa and I obviously went there, and that was the kind of plan to sort of was to, you know, work up there. Things changed a little bit. I did reach out to, I think, 7 companies. Of the 7, I had conversations with 3 of them. For 2 of them, the timing just didn't really work out, but there was interest and there's potential of maybe doing something in the future with them. And then for the 3rd one, it was pretty much good to go. And it was with a fishing guide company up there, actually. So a few different fishing company things lately. But sweet business, awesome owner, and hopefully I get to work with him in the future. But it was also kind of a matter of timing. Our trip was a lot shorter than it was originally intended to be. And also Lisa's schedule changed quite a bit while we're up there too. So I didn't want to kind of, you know, be up there when Lisa's not working and she's kind of with the family, and then I'm out there working and I don't get to really, you know, hang out with anybody and stuff. So again, things changed a little bit. Probably still could have pushed it through, but it would have been a good chunk of the time that we're up there, and I kind of just decided to focus on relaxing a little bit and spending time with Lisa and the family and enjoying that time basically up there. So a bit of a change of plans, but did go to show that, you know, 3 out of 7 people were interested in and wanted to have conversations. And that didn't take all that long to, you know, research those companies and reach out to them. So yeah, it just goes to show the potential or the power of, you know, a simple email that's well worded and has some good ideas and is genuine. So that was cool to see. I also put up 2 more videos on YouTube. As you may have noticed, both are in the creating playlist. And one was from, what was that from? Thanksgiving. And it was a chance to use my new Ronin S gimbal. So I was just kind of playing around with that. And then the other one was, the drone video. It features the first shot with this bad boy kind of approaching a waterfall. So if you haven't seen that yet, go check it out. It was super fun. I got a lot of cool drone footage up in Terrace. There's a lot of room to fly up there. It's not very busy. Much smaller town than here in Vancouver, obviously. So got a really cool chance to fly around and learn the craft a little bit more. So that was cool. And then last thing on the updates, this is the biggest section. So I know this is already probably going a bit long, but last thing in the updates is I've officially registered my business as a content creator and got a GST number. Small thing, but it's just another step forward towards, you know, this sort of full-time self-employed as an independent content creator, which, you know, I've done different variations of that in the future, or in the past rather. I've had a few different jobs throughout the year as I've kind of shared in these updates and stuff too. This is kind of, you know, another step forward for me and for my business as a content creator. So it makes it a little bit more legit. And unfortunately I gotta charge GST now, so you missed the discount, but we'll still figure something out if you want to work together. So anyways, that's that. Learnings. I've been learning a lot lately. Learnings, I would say, some of the top ones were I had to learn like basic Adobe After Effects for a client project. And this was, you know, there's text kind of appearing in a few different places throughout the video. And rather than just, you know, static text kind of with a solid background on it so you can actually read it, had to figure out ways to work in text, have it moving in, sliding in, or appearing. In different ways and things. So I think I bought a template off somebody for some like pre-made kind of animations. And then you have to bring those inside Adobe After Effects and then tweak them kind of how you need them basically. And that good stuff. Learned the kind of the basics of that, and really cool to see how the different Adobe programs talk to each other. You know, when you're doing one thing inside After Effects and you save that file, you bring it into Adobe Premiere, and you start editing it with it in Premiere, if you change the file in After Effects, it automatically updates that file in Premiere. So it's it really cool how it kind of works together and just sort of, you know, learning how to sort of piece all that together and how those programs talk to each other and stuff. So yeah, that's been cool. Definitely going to be a big value add in a lot of my future projects and stuff for clients as well. So excited to kind of be opening that door, and I'm sure there's lots, of course, lots more to learn there and stuff too. So yeah. What else? Learn to use a new camera gear. Yeah, this drone was not easy to figure out personally to start with. I think I was in a zone that required authorization, so just having to go through that first flight, having to go through applying for a permit in that area. It wasn't like a restricted area or anything like that, but you know, just being able to kind of go through that process of going online onto the website there and yeah, applying for that, you know, 24-hour permit and then finally getting the thing in the air after charging it, figuring out how to use it, calibrating it, all that stuff. So yeah, that's been a big learning. And then also the Ronin-S, the stabilizer, that was a bit of a learning as well, obviously, with just balancing the camera for the first time and learning the buttons and things of that nature. So it's been really good, you know, learning new gear and how that works with my camera and stuff and what this can add to sort of what I'm already doing as a content creator as well. So yeah, that's been really cool. Last thing would be, I've been watching a lot of YouTube videos about photo editing specifically. I feel like I want to improve my game on photo editing and photography in general. I feel like I take decent photos and I think I have an eye for good framing, but I think the editing is sort of where I lack a little bit, and I think I come out with a lot of the same sort of looks all the time, but I'd love to get to a place where, you know, I can up that a little bit and start to do some really unique things with my photos and stuff. You know, shout out to the master himself, Peter McKinnon, for having some really good, you know, tutorials, and also love his series that, you know, where he talks about or he edits other people's photos that they submit. They send in, you know, raw photos, and then kind of he takes his interpretation on how to edit it and stuff. And I think that's one of the best ways for me to learn, is just seeing exactly how someone else is doing it. And then I can pick up little bits and pieces kind of along the way and sort of, you know, apply that to, you know, my style and kind of how I want things to look. So yeah, that's been great. Spending a lot of time just learning right now, which has been great. Yeah, a couple wins. Went on an epic road trip with the broskies up to Seton Lake, just outside of Lillooet in BC here. It's like 4 or 5 hours north of Vancouver, just past, you know, Whistler and Pemberton. It was really beautiful up there. Had a chance to shoot like star photos, like legit star photos for the first time. So that was really cool. Shout out Allie for, you know, coaching me a little bit on how to set up the camera and settings to use and things like that. So that was super cool. And yeah, came up with some really, really nice shots. So yeah, that was a big win. And then also October, I know it's November 10th now, I believe. Yeah, I haven't done an update in, you know, a month or so. And I would just say last month, October, was by far my best month of the year in terms of, you know, revenue generating. And yeah, just was really busy the whole month and had a lot of inbound stuff coming in. So that was, you know, really encouraging and awesome to see. But November has been a lot different, a lot slower, a lot less inbound. So yeah, that kind of leads me to the challenges here, I guess, which I'll get into. You know, first one just being, I need to make more time for business development. I think it's easy to lean on inbound. And of course, if you have a good inbound funnel, then you're killing it. You're doing great. And you've obviously, you know, been doing your thing. You've got a good network, all that good stuff. And there's a few things in there that I do have, but generally speaking, as a content creator, I'm still, you know, somewhat new to this. Even though I've been in the industry for a long time, I haven't been, you know, hands-on with cameras for all that long. So I think that, actually this is like a two for one, because I'm going to talk about the next challenge, is that I don't have a lot of projects yet that I'm like super confident in putting forward and sharing with a prospective client saying, hey, you know, this is an edit I did and it's similar to what you're looking to have done. You know, I don't have a lot of those examples yet. So I really need to get out there and either land some projects, but also at the same time, if I have this downtime and this sort of time in between projects, then going out and finding people that need videos and just doing them for free or for, you know, at cost, whatever that might look like, just to get that experience under my belt and have more projects I can point towards. You know, and be really proud of, and also that's a learning experience too. So there's just so much value that comes from just just doing things, just creating projects. So that's something I need to do more of, and I've got a few ideas already kind of cooking up, and maybe I'll have some updates again next time on any of those that move forward. So so that was need to make time for biz dev, need more examples of video work specifically, and then the last challenge I would say is working from home. I love working from home, I've said this before, and I do well working alone, but it's been a long time now, and I feel like, I haven't really been going to the VRIO office as much anymore as I used to in the past, you know, few months and stuff either, because my workstation is here, all my gear is here, it's just easier to kind of be here around all my stuff and lighting and all those kinds of things. So, with working from home, there's just so many distractions, and it's so easy when you're not, you know, under a deadline or you don't have a bunch of projects going on at the moment, then it's easy to, you know, take some downtime, which is not a bad thing either. Here and there, it's nice to take a bit of a break. And I feel like I've, you know, been grinding pretty hard for the past few years, especially in kind of Jota era there. It's nice to catch up a little bit and have a breather. But I'm the kind of person that likes to be hustling and making money and feeling fulfilled with my work. So yeah, I just find that sometimes being at home is a little bit unmotivating, and I crave having a studio a little bit again. So I think that might be a goal for next year, is to get to a point where, you know, I'm doing enough client work and I've built up sort of my monthly recurring revenue specifically so that, you know, I can launch back into getting a studio and maybe even using that to rent it out alongside my own projects and stuff, of course, as well. But yeah, I think that'd be sweet to do that. So maybe that's, yeah, a goal for next year. We'll see. But I think it's likely. That's today's update. That's everything. It's been good. I didn't exactly feel like coming in front of the camera today, but I'm glad I did. It feels good to just kind of talk through things and think through, you know, what have I been doing? What am I struggling with right now? I find it's a good exercise and kind of therapeutic to go through that. So if you watched all the way through, that's amazing. I really appreciate it. Thank you. And even if you caught a little bit of it, then that's sweet too. So thanks a lot for the support, you guys. And I'll be back soon with another video. Until then, peace and love.